What does the heart do? Have you seen this bathtub? You have seen it, bathed in it, but not observed it. Today you go to your hotel, let some water there, put the stopcock. And when the water is to a certain level, stop the water, pull the stopcock. Watch the water. Goes, you don't see it. When the end comes, boom, it... That's called whirling. And the whirling gives it energy, and that energy makes the water flow. So in the human body also, the heart cannot pump blood. It's a 300 gram muscular structure. And you have 8 lakhs kilometers of capillaries into which even an RBC cannot flow easily. So it requires 142 horsepower for one pumping. So first pumping itself, the patient will die. So you're all alive here. That means it's not pumping. What does the heart do? Have you seen anatomies here? Heart muscle is a peculiar structure. It's got a twisted muscle. It's called higgledy-piggledy muscular. So what does the heart do? It gives it a twist. So from the swimming pool, through the veins, the blood is sucked into the heart. Does not flow. It is sucked positively into the heart. And then it gives a twist and it moves on to the artery. And then with whirling, it goes. I'll show you. See, this inside the vessel, if you see, this is how it flows. Not laminarly. You're teaching your students laminar flow of blood. If you really understand laminar flow, the outer lamina doesn't flow at all. The inner lamina flows a little faster, inner is a little faster, innermost fastest. Now you give a vasodilator for lowering the blood pressure, what happens? Nothing happens. Only the inner core runs a little faster and kills somebody. That's all what happens. This is very interesting. It should have come first. This slide came later. Recently, somebody did 3,000 original studies in medicine to show what we are doing to the patients. See that? More than half, 60%, are not of no known effectiveness at all. And the beneficial is only 3%. Can you believe that? 3%. That means 97% of the patients, you send them to meet their maker in heaven. How many of you have heard the science of rheology? Good. It's a new branch of physics. Rheology deals with the fluid flow. And if you know rheology, you will forget Newton's laws of deterministic spread, equally gravity, blah, 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 blah. You put liquid helium in a bottle, not bottle, a bowl, and keep it on a table. Liquid helium. And you will watch it. The second day, the helium starts coming up. There's a little helium at the bottom, liquid helium. It comes up, goes up, walks up, goes to the brim, and falls down. You hold liquid helium in a silicon bottle and hold it up. Leave it there. 24 hours later, this helium leaks through the silicon bottle. No holes there. Aye, sir, darji, idhar hai. Aapke liye rakha hai. Aye. Idhar aye. Tashrif rakhiye. Aye, idhar aye. We welcome all the, the flyoff. Airport is so far away in Bangalore, it's inhuman. Because even if you land on time, it takes about an hour and a half, nearly 2 hours to come here. We were just talking about rheology, sir. So all the gravity, that you mugged up for passing your intermediate physics or PUC physics, you should forget it now. Now in the PUC, teachers teach you something in physics. Even when I was a student, they were teaching. Laminar flow in a tube cannot produce lateral pressure, because if it produces lateral pressure, it can't flow further. Cosine 90 is zero. So I mugged it up, otherwise I won't go to the medical college. Mugged it up. Went to the physiology class. Then Sarada Subramaniam said, blood pressure is a lateral pressure exerted on the vessel wall by the flowing blood. I mugged it up. I had forgotten what my teacher taught in physics. Now I am saying blood pressure is a lateral pressure exerted on the vessel wall by the flowing blood. If it flows really pressure at lateral pressure, it can't flow. And if it is a laminar flow, it's okay. But it's a whirling flow. See? So what is blood pressure? God only knows. I am supposed to be doing research on blood pressure for 40 years. I have written a book on blood pressure. Now if you ask me, I don't know what blood pressure is. This rheology is, the flow depends on the kind of fluid inside. You see the honey, You drop the honey, it just doesn't settle like water. It settles, there's a little peak there, and then you leave it, it settles down. That is why in America, the honey bottle dispensers are different. In our bottle, you take and then eat it and keep it. The honey goes all over the place and then ants come. This madam knows that. She was troubled by the ants. Now, this is rheology. See now, this is the blood vessel, the real human blood vessel. How blood is flowing? Seeing this also, they say, again go and teach. Flowing blood in the laminar flow, there's lateral pressure. Now see, how the flow depends only on shear stress, on systolic pressure, diastolic pressure, what have you, depends on suspensoids and colloids. Suspensoids are RBCs, WBCs, this, that, and things like that. Colloids are anions, cations, etc., etc. Of course, there are crystalloids, that's a different thing. A lot of things, and not just the... Now, we all taught Starling's laws. And do you know what Starling said? Heart is a peculiar structure. I did vivisection, dissected, did not understand how the heart functions. Now I think I'll confine myself to systole, which I can understand, and forget about diastole. He wrote that, but you teach systole is active, diastole is passive, nothing happens in diastole, blood simply comes back. But Narayana Suktani, Dasha Suktani, 10,000 years ago wrote, beautifully wrote, it wrote, the heart is like a lotus bud kept upside down with the tip slightly to the left, and at the root arises a huge stalk which takes God's energy to all parts of the body. How true it is in physics today? It is the energy of rheology, energy of whirling that takes blood to every corner of your body, otherwise you and I will not be alive. Now we know a New York surgeon, incidentally he's an Indian born New York surgeon, a venologist, has shown that if you inject a little dye into the vein, the dye jumps from one vein valve to another vein valve. It's called venous dance. He calls it as venous dance. Jumps. And it's sucked into the atrium. And this is called a venous dance. And eventually, it comes to the right atrium. This is now published. He has published it just last year. He has been working for 10 years. And this boy is from Bangalore Medical College. So, they transplant it to a vein here. And in 2 months' time, the leg is normal. Now you go to a doctor, and in the physiology class you teach. The ECG is regular sinus rhythm, absolute, right now? Right? If it is really regular, you are dead. In real physiology, rhythmia is death, arrhythmia is health. And this is your heart. This is a healthy heart. And we have been studying this for the last 25 years. And this is what we used to do in the olden days. Of course, first I started with medical students and ordinary polygraphs. So I used to have x-axis your heart rate, y-axis your heart rate delayed slightly, mathematically. And then see how, now of course we do it on a computer, and see how now this is your heart rate. This is your own heart rate with a mathematical delay. You see how it is a chaotic thing? This is called healthy chaos. So everything in the human body is dynamic. Blood pressure goes up and down like that. You catch it here, you go high blood pressure. Catch it here, you go low blood pressure. There's nothing called blood pressure like that, except when you're dead. Blood sugar is like this. It's not steady. We did a study, very interesting study. We pricked 10 fingers of medical students with 10 minutes. In 10 minutes, you prick 10 fingers and study the blood sugar. If all the 10 readings are identical, either he is a very bad diabetic or he's going to be a diabetic. But if the 10 readings are 10 different readings, he will never be a diabetic in his life. He has got a healthy chaos. This applies to blood pressure also. A lot of patients come, sir, I came yesterday, it was 122, and today it is 120, sir. So, sir, that must be something very seriously wrong. I said, very seriously wrong, because you're alive. And there are doctors who get 125 blood pressure. Have you seen that? There is no 5 in that box. They invented a 5. That box was invented by the Riva Rossi, Stipone Riva Rossi. That fellow, I am told, is turning in his grave saying that the abuse and the misuse these doctors put it into is something phenomenal, and they killed millions. I have published a study just about 2 months ago, 1,000 medical students. What we did was we checked their blood pressure and then frightened them. Next checking, it goes up. check their blood pressure, and then other limb you put a tourniquet and block the brachial artery, blood pressure goes up. Just check the blood pressure as we do, push, 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 and then it push, 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 will goes up, and then you search for a stethoscope, it's paining, he says, hurting, sir. Blood pressure has gone up to the sky. You want that because everybody is labeled hypertensive. This is called white coat hypertension. Now see this patient. This fellow's heart rate doesn't move at all. He is very steady, like the physiology class. Regular heart rate. He was dead in 2 hours. Now over the years, what we have done is, we have put a CWT pattern. It's a computer thing, very mathematical, don't worry about it. But what I want to see is, I want you to see this picture. You see this, this is a healthy heart. Now if you see the same heart that I showed you and see the pattern, this is CW, a continuous wavelet transform. It's a very complicated mathematics, don't worry about that. But look at the picture, it's a healthy heart. Look at this heart rate, this is a healthy heart. Now go to this heart, see, it's absolutely regular. All the pumpkins are in one row and this patient is dead in no time. You are a human cell. That's what I want you to concentrate on. This is a human cell. The most important part of the human cell is the cell wall. All this bilipid, etc., you mugged it in the book. All that I want you to see is this. This is the integral membrane protein which conducts things from inside and outside. But these antennae are there. The day you are made in your mother's womb, you are a zygote, one cell, one cell. That one cell is you today. 1 trillion, 100 trillion cells. That one cell had this antenna, and this antenna gets its message from the universal consciousness. You are born. The day this antenna stops receiving it, you are dead. Did you understand that? An anatomist studied this. See? Anatomist did not study dead body. He studied live cells. His name is Bruce Lipton, professor of cellular biology in the Massachusetts Medical School. What did he do? He put this inside in a live media and then studied it. Did not even go out of the room, electron microscope room, studied. And he found things happening. He found the cell becoming live. And Bruce was an atheist, agnostic. When he saw the cell becoming live, he completely converted. He became, oh, there is something beyond man. Up until then, he thought man is running the whole thing. You know, as professor of anatomy, he was running the whole world. Then he realized, no, I'm not running it, someone else is running it. Then he realized that human life is like the television screen. You put the switch on, Hema Malini is dancing. Then you switch off, Hema Malini is dead. Hema Malini is not in the box, but Hema Malini is waves, energy waves for a dancer in the box. Now that same wave, you put go to another room and switch it on, she is dancing there. Same thing happens to you. Dying is the switch connection goes off and immediately connects to another cell, another zygote. When he knew this, he wrote a book for you. Biology of Belief. Read this book, Biology of Belief. Bruce Lipton is the name. Lipton, T, you know, T. Bruce, add to that. It's a fascinating book. And then, there is another girl who was doing a lot of work in this area, and she was, of course, she was to get the Nobel Prize, her boss got the Nobel Prize. This is how, what happens, you know, you write the paper and the boss gets the first. This is what happened to her also, Saul Snyder, her name is Candace Pert. But she, of course, fought. She went to the Nobel Committee, showed her work and showed them, and his Nobel Prize was withdrawn. But this girl has written a book for you called Molecules of Emotion. It's a fascinating book, nice book, Molecules of Emotion. Author's name is Candace, C-A-N-D-A-C-E, Pert, P-E-R-T. And this girl's book is very good. Now then come, this is how the ligand, the connection comes. This is the girl, Candace. This is Bruce. Now we come back to what work we are doing on this area of holistic medicine. We took this, one of my colleagues was the greatest scientist the world had ever known. He was nominated for the Nobel 21 times, but they denied him the Nobel. His students, two of his students got Nobel. He didn't get it because he praises Indian things and so he doesn't get it. He is an American. He converted himself to Christianity and lives in America with an American wife. Now, of course, he's dead. He's 89. May his soul rest in peace. His name is Rustum Roy. He was the man who was invited by the government of India to study the science institutions here, and he told them all of them need to be completely revamped. Now he took this from the Rigveda. Rigveda has this stolen clone, Urj. Do you know what it says in short? Water is the mother of fire. Water is the mother, father of fire, Agni. All energy comes from water. And so we said, let us see. So this is a silver mesh, and we put water on that, and silver nanoparticles get deposited. And we wanted to convert man into a salamander. You cut the salamander's tail, have you seen that? Palli palli at home. It grows. Your tail also grows if you cut. But only thing is, salamander can do it on its own. For you, we have to help it. Now, this boy lost his fingertip. He lost his fingertip on 16th May 1995 in a machine. It went off. He didn't have money to re-suture it. So what we did was, we covered it with a silver thing and put some water and changed the polarity from negative to positive with the 9.9 volt battery. See, on the third day, it is so clean. No infection. Nobody has touched it. And after a month, it started growing. After another month, it started growing. Now it has completely grown into a finger. And if you want to know what it was like that. Here is a police, retired IG in Madras. This is his foot, diabetic foot. And they wanted to chop it off. The man refused because he said, if you chop off the foot when you are alive, next janma you will not have a foot itself, it seems, according to him. You and I don't believe it, we laugh at it, but he believed it, he wanted to die with it. So ultimately, there was a good surgeon called Murli. I told Murli, you clean it, let us see. He cleaned it, so we cleaned it, and then did our trick. The man has a foot, complete foot, normal foot. Not only that, watch this. This is the foot, diabetic foot is always very fat, because growth, insulin is growth hormone, hyperinsulinemia. You see, the foot has become normal. This lady is here in the audience, sitting there. She came to me with blocks everywhere. Every vessel is blocked. Blood pressure 240, 140, etc., etc. And see this complete block at the abdominal aorta just after the renal artery has taken off. So I have the same device, put it here. She is walking now. And she is very fine. But what happened? After 3 months, you see, like a horse tail, lot of new vessels have grown. And the runoff is so good. She has a very good femoral artery. Her blood pressure has come down. Her stroke has recovered. And she didn't have a heart attack because she was told that she will have a heart attack because all the vessels are blocked. And she is fine and walking about, all because her husband believed in what we did. And he didn't go for 4 bypass surgeries in the heart, in the neck, in the leg, in the abdomen. She would have been with her maker by now. This is a very famous film actress dancer in Madras. Her disc was removed by 44 lakhs operation in a 5-star corporate hospital. Then she was in the wheelchair all the time. And she was crying. So anyway, now she is dancing. So what has happened? Medicalization of society. We are pushing people into the bottomless pit by giving our treatment. But all that we did has no impact on society, because whether you treat them or don't treat them, the curve is the same. It has only shifted a little because you have sent them a little early to the other world. See here, this is 17 studies of blood pressure treatment in the world, starting from the original MRC study of mild to moderate hypertension, the European study, the Australasian study, and now come to every study, EWPST and everything. And all the studies together showed that relative risk reduction is very good, but absolute risk reduction is hardly anything. You know the two things, relative risk reduction and absolute risk reduction? You don't know. Very interesting. We fool people in the paper showing only the relative risk reduction. We don't tell them about absolute risk reduction. I have treated 100 patients. 5 of them survived. 10 should have died, but only 5 died. So I have reduced the risk by 50%. My statistical estimate is this group of patients, I predict 10% must die. I have given the treatment, only 5% died. So 50% reduction. That's called relative risk reduction, RRR. If you took absolute risk reduction, you have done nothing. So all these blood pressure trial errors have showed that you did nothing. What helped them is change of mode of living. Tranquility of mind, food and moderation and proper diet, and they all survive and have, irrespective of what the blood pressure is. Come now. We say we have controlled all the infections. Long before we even came on the scene, infections had almost disappeared. There are better graphs than this. This one graph I have showed you, how even before the BCG had come, tuberculosis had almost come to that level. But now, from 1900, tuberculosis is going up. India is the most dangerous country because 9% primary resistance of tuberculosis. Bus, taxi, anywhere you can get TB. This is incidence of TB going up globally. We say we have a very good, we have treatment, we have this, we have DOT, we have this and sanatorium and all. This is a fantastic study. They took 5,000 Swedish men and then told them, one group, you told them, do what you like, their control group. The other group, they were told, come to us, free, we will give you treatment for everything and we'll correct everything. So you see, after 15 years, 3 times more people died in the intervened group. The control group are very happy going about. Then somebody said, okay, that is all total death, but heart death would have certainly come. See, heart death. Twice the number of people died in the intervened group. Blood pressure, you must control it. Otherwise, you know, it's the silent killer will kill everybody. And we have been killing people after 5 years of treating blood pressure. Now, this is our effort for the last about 15 years. And Professor Rustum Roy was the founder. And we have been able to get it. This is a journal. And this, my co-editor-in-chief is the Professor Rustum Roy. He was in the beginning till he died. Then now Hans-Peter Dior, Nobel Prize, Emeritus Director, Max Planck Institute. And this is Hans-Peter Dior. He's 86. He came over 2 months ago here, lectured. Now this is the editorial board. You see the who is who in the world of science all over the world. And this is the first editorial board. Rustum Roy here. Joey Jones, one of the greatest cancer surgeons who does not treat cancer with his treatment, but with pranic healing. And our friend Hans-Peter Dior. Friends, we are in the ne plus ultra stage. We know everything, there's nothing beyond us. So we have our study, our publications, everything. That was the Spanish flag before America was discovered. Ne plus ultra was their choice. Like Satyameva Jayate, which is also not true. Anratameva Jayate na Satyam, that's what's happening in India. Now come to the flag now. After Columbus discovered America, they knew there's something more. So they removed that ne. They call it as plus ultra, more beyond. So friends, science has to go from ne plus ultra to plus ultra. Thank you very much.